Hello students, today I am going to brief you people regarding your BSc third semester syllabus which is prescribed by Rani Chennamma University, Belagavi and which will be an introductory part for today. Before we proceed to our integral part of syllabus, let us investigate the term cryptogams. Yes, the term cryptogams. You might be thinking why, isn't it? We will come to know in our syllabus part why it is necessary to understand the term cryptograms before we proceed to our actual syllabus. So let's start. Here comes the cryptograms, which is the epitome of our syllabus. Here cryptograms, the cryptograms, a plant that has no true flowers or seeds, including ferns, mosses, liverworts, lichens, algae and fungi. What are these? The plant that has no true flowers or seeds, including ferns, mosses, liverworts, lichens, algae and fungi. These are the members, they do not show the flowers, either the seed formation. Hence, they are kept under cryptograms. Here, the name cryptograms. Why? Why the name cryptograms? The name is given to them because they do not produce flowers nor seeds and they reproduce only by the mode of spore formation. Hence, the name given as cryptogam. The plural form cryptogam is cryptogams. The origin, the name of the cryptograms comes from the Greek word. It is the Greek terminology where cryptos refer to hidden, gamos refers to marriage, that is hidden marriage, because the meaning is the reproduction was not apparent. Apparent means it is not visible. The reproduction takes place only through the spore formation, hence the name given cryptograms, which is cryptos, hidden, gamos refers to marriage. Later in modern Latin, it is given as cryptogame, which is included in the kingdom Plantae. Later in French, it is termed as cryptogam. Later in mid 19th century, it is termed to be cryptogam. It is called as cryptogram from the 19th century, mid 19th century. Here in 1883, Itchela classified the whole plant kingdom into two subkingdoms, such as cryptograms and phanerograms. In 1883, Itchela classified the whole plant kingdom into two subkingdoms, such as cryptograms and phanerograms. Here we got to know what are cryptograms. What are cryptograms? These are the plants. Those do not reproduce flowers nor seeds. Then what are phanerograms? The opposite to the cryptograms. The phanerograms are the plants which are able and capable of producing, reproducing the flowers and the seeds. Those are called as phanerograms. And it is said to be a traditional classification in plants, which is the division of two subkingdoms, that is cryptograms and phanerograms. That is termed the traditional of classification in plants. Here are the few characteristic features of cryptogamy. And the following are the important features of cryptograms. Here only we confined to the term cryptograms, which is important for us. Here we leave the phanerograms. First one. The features of cryptograms is, first one, these are the lower plants. Second, these bear no flowers, seeds and fruits. Hence, they are kept under cryptograms. Third one, these reproduce vegetatively, asexually and sexually. The vegetative reproduction takes place through cell division or fragmentation. They either grow for the cell division or for the fragmentation. Asexual reproduction takes place by means of spore formation. The sexual reproduction takes place by fusion of male and female gametes. As we said, the sexual reproduction takes place by the fusion of male and female gametes. Here we have the types. Which are those? First one is the isogamous, anisogamous, and oogamous. The fusion of the gametes depends upon the types of gametes they are going to fuse. They are termed as isogamous, anisogamous, and oogamous. We will see one by one. In first case, in isogamy. Isogamy is the process of fusing isogamous spores. Here, gametes of similar size, shape, and behavior fuse together. What? Here, the same or the similar size, shape, and behavior of gametes, those fuse together to form isogamy. It is seen in primitive cryptograms. Isogamy is usually seen in primitive cryptograms. In anisogamy, exactly opposite to the isogamy. Here, two fusion gametes slightly differ in size and behavior. In anisogamy, the two gametes, they are slightly differ in size and behavior. In third condition, in oogamous type, the female gamete is larger and non-motile, while the male gamete is smaller in size and motile. The size is smaller compared to the female one. Here, female gamete is larger. The female gamete is known as megagamete, and the male gamete is known as microgamete, because mega refers to large, micro refers to small. Due to large in size, the female gamete is known to be megagamete. Due to small in size compared to the female gamete, the male gamete is called microgamete. It is also known to be anthrozoites or spermatozoite. Which one? For the male gametes. Next, oogamy takes place in advanced cryptograms. As I mentioned above, in primitive cryptograms, the isogamy is the process. In advanced cryptograms, oogamy is the process and the mode of reproduction. Advanced cryptograms such as liverworts, mosses, pteridophytes, and algae undergoes alternation of generation. This is important, which is the alternation of generation. That is, these go through two phases to complete their life cycle. The two phases are sporophytic phase and gametophytic phase. Here, they undergo two phases to complete their life cycle. That is called to be the alternation of generation. The sporophytic phase is characterized by asexual reproduction, while in gametophytic phase, the sexual reproduction takes place. The alternation of generation means here the both sexual and asexual reproduction takes place alternatively. The sporophytic phase is diploid, that is 2n in number, while the gametophytic phase is haploid, n in number. That is, sporophytic phase is diploid, 2n stage, while the gametophytic phase is haploid, n in stage. The two phase occur in alternation, that is, one after the other, hence the alternation of generation. Here comes the classification of cryptogamy. Here, the cryptograms are further divided into three groups, such as thallophyta, bryophyta, pteridophyta. What are they? Three types. First one, bryophyta. First one, thallophyta. Second one is bryophyta. And third one is pteridophytes. First one, thallophyte. What are thallophytes? Here we will see. These include algae, fungi, bacteria, and lichens. The thallophytes includes algae, fungi, bacteria, and lichens. These are the simplest plants where the body is not differentiated into roots, leaves, and stems. Usually, if you characterize the plants, what we will see? We will see the roots, leaves, and stems. But in thallophytes, these are not differentiated into roots, leaves, and stems. Hence, they are thallophytes. The simplest thallophytes are bacteria. among algae, fungi, bacteria and lichens. The simplest telophyte is bacteria. These are aquatic plants that can grow in fresh as well as in marine water. They lack vascular system. Vascular system, that is the xylem and phloem. Next comes bryophyta. What are bryophytes? These include liverworts, horned liverworts, and mosses. These are also an undifferentiated plant with no vascular tissue. We are seen in telophytes. Those are also undifferentiated plant with no vascular tissue. Same in bryophytes. These are the undifferentiated plant with no vascular tissue. These have rhizoids. What are rhizoids? The root-like structures to attach, to hold. These are generally found in damp and moist places. These can grow both on land and in water. These are the simplest of all land plants and also known as amphibians of the plant kingdom. Which one? Bryophytes. Usually, bryophytes are called as the amphibians of the plant kingdom because they grow on land, but they require water to complete its reproduction. Hence, they are called amphibians of plant kingdom. Here comes third one, pteridophytes. These includes all kinds of ferns. These have well differentiated plant body and vascular system. See, compared to our telophytes and bryophytes, here pteridophytes are more advanced because here we can see the well differentiated plant body and the vascular system. Here the formation of xylem, phloem are seen. These are also known as vascular cryptograms because the vascular system starts from pteridophytes. Hence, they are called vascular cryptograms. These are most advanced of all cryptograms because, as I said, here we can see well-differentiated plant body and the presence of vascular system. In the most accepted five kingdom of classification by Whittaker, bacteria are placed as a separate kingdom known as kingdom Monera. In five kingdom of classification by the Whittaker, the bacteria are placed as a separate kingdom known as kingdom Monera. In the same way, fungi are also excluded from the plant kingdom and placed separately as kingdom fungi. As these lack chlorophylls, which are the characteristic feature of plant kingdom. Usually the algae and the fungi they come under a symbiotic relationship forming the lichens. Why? Because in algae the presence of chlorophyll, they are autotrophs, they are capable of synthesizing their own food material. But in case of fungi, they lack the chlorophyll pigment, hence they are heterotrophs. They are not able to produce their own food material. So they come in association, symbiotic association, one giving the shelter and other giving the food. They form the lichens. That's why bacteria and fungi, they are placed separately from the kingdom plantae. Yes. Here comes our actual syllabus. The Ranchanama University, Belagavi, the botany optional for third semester students. Your paper is the diversity of cryptograms. That's why we discussed little about the term cryptograms. Under the cryptograms, we will study algae, fungi, bryophytes, pteridophytes, and gymnosperms. That is paper, the diversity of cryptograms. Now you can able to tell me what are cryptograms, isn't it? What are cryptograms? These are the plants that are not able to produce a flowers or seeds. Such plants are placed under cryptograms. Here we will study one by one. Which one? Algae, fungi, bryophytes, pteridophytes, and gymnosperms. The total allotted period is for 52 hours. The syllabus is for 52 hours. Under the 52 hours, the 10 hours allotted for the unit 1, that is algae. Our unit 1 is algae. Under algae, we will study. Before, what are algae? We all people know what are algae, fungi, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms. Yes, I will recall you. Algae are the photosynthetic organisms that possesses photosynthetic pigments such as chlorophyll. However, they lack true roots, stems, and leaves characterized by vascular plants. Some of them are unicellular and others of multicellular. The scientific study of algae is called phycology. Usually, the scientific study of algae is called as phycology. Under algae, we will study first one, the general characters of algae. Second, the pigmentation in algae, the classification given by the Fritsch up to class level. Next comes distribution of algae, thallus structure, reproduction and life cycle in Nostoc, Volvox, Oodogonium, Sargassum, Protacospermum. These are the examples. We will study the reproduction and the life cycle. The last comes the economic importance of algae. Next, under unit 2, that is fungi, the given period is 8 hours. Here we will study the general characters, classification, distribution, structure, reproduction and life cycle of albigo, rhizopus, penicillium, pakshinia. Here again the economics importance of fungi, the general account of lichens. As I stated before, lichens, these are the symbiotic association of algal and fungal members. Those are called as lichens. Here, what are fungi? These are usually multicellular eukaryotic organisms that are heterotrophs. Why? These cannot make their own food and have important roles in nutrient cycling in an ecosystem. Usually, fungi reproduce both sexually and asexually. They also have symbiotic association with plants and bacteria. Here, the unicellular fungus is which one? Yes, exactly. The yeast is unicellular fungus. The multicellular fungi is the mold. The fruiting body is which one? Commonly we see in the rainy season. Yes, correct. Mushrooms. The mushrooms are the fruiting body. These are the three major types of fungus that we can study under this category. Mushrooms, molds and yeast. Here comes our third unit, that is plant pathology. What is plant pathology? Generally, it is said as the scientific study of disease in plants caused by pathogens. What is plant pathology? The scientific study of disease in plants caused by pathogens. Here, usually, organisms that cause infection disease include fungi, oomycetes, bacteria, viruses and virids. Under viruses like protozoa, nematodes and parasitic plants. Here we will study the general account of bacteria and viruses because those are considered as pathogens which can attack the plant. Next, the introduction of plant pathology. Next comes the general symptoms of plant diseases. Next, pathogens and control measures of late blight of potato, white rust of crucifers, tikka disease of groundnut. He will study in detail the pathogens, which are the pathogens that causes disease to the plant and the control measures, how we can get rid of the infection. We will study mainly the late blight of potato. Second, white rust of crucifers. Third one is tikka disease of groundnut. Next, under unit 4, that is bryophytes. Under bryophytes, we will see general characters, classification given by Smith, structure, reproduction, and schematic life cycle of Rickettsia, Anthoceros, and Funaria. Examples are Rickettsia, Anthoceros, Funaria, and evolution of sporophytes. How the sporophytes get evolved, that we will study in bryophytes, that is the evolution of sporophytes. Usually, what are bryophytes? These are informal group consisting of three divisions of non-vascular land plants, the liverworts, hornworts, and mosses. They are characterized limited in size and prefer moist habitats, although they can survive in drier environment. Hence, they are given the amphibians of plant kingdom. They are generally called the amphibians of plant kingdom. Amphi refers to two. They can live in water as well as in drier area. Here, in next part, in pteridophytes, first of all, what are pteridophytes? These are first true land plants because they show well-differentiated plant body and the presence of vascular system. Hence, they are called as the first true land plants. Next, pteridophytes are plants that do not have any flowers or seeds. Hence, another name for pteridophyte is cryptogram. Here, we can describe them as cryptogram because here they don't show the flowers or seeds. They include ferns and horse tails, club mosses, and these reproduce by spores and have vascular tissue, roots, stems, and leaves. Under pteridophytes, we will study first one, it's the general characters, classification, the distribution of pteridophytes, the structure, that is external and internal structure of pteridophytes, the reproduction in xylotum, Selaginella, Equisetum, Nephrolepis. Next comes stellar evolution. Why stellar evolution? From pteridophytes, we will see the presence of xylem and phloem. Hence, we will study this stellar evolution from pteridophytes. Here, heterospory and seed habitat. Here comes gymnosperms. What are gymnosperms? Again, these are flowerless plants that produce cones and seeds. Here we'll see the production of cones and seeds. The term gymnosperm literally means naked seed. As gymnosperm seeds are not encased within an ovary. This can be visible to our naked eyes. Hence, they are naked seeds. Gymnosperms, any vascular plant that reproduce by means of an exposed seed or ovule, unlike the angiosperms or the flowering plants whose seeds are enclosed by mature ovaries or fruits. The seeds of many gymnosperms, literally naked seeds, are born in cones and are not visible until maturity. Most of cones, they are visible after the maturity of the cones. Under the gymnosperm, here we study its general characters, its classification, the distribution, structure, both the external structure and internal structure of the gymnosperm, reproduction in cycas, pinus, and neatum. Example, the reproduction in cycas, pinus, and neatum. Here comes our last unit, that is palynobotany. What is palynobotany? It is generally quoted as the study of fossil plants. The study of fossil plants is known to be palynobotany. Palynobotany is the scientific study of ancient plants using plant fossils found in sedimentary rocks. These fossils can be impression or compression of plant left on the rock surface or petrified objects such as wood, which preserve the original plant material in rock-like form. Here, under the palynobotany, we will study the geological timescale. What are the geological time scale? Which are the eras comes in geological time period? And the fossilization. Fossilization is the process of molds, impression, petrification, and casting. Last comes the study of fossils. The study of fossils, under the fossils, we will have three types: calamities, lepidodendron, and lignopteris. These are the three examples for the study of fossils. This is a little review on your syllabus, and we will come with next session with your actual syllabus and the information. So here we wind up our this session, and I hope you people quite clear regarding your syllabus. So in the next session, I will come up with your actual syllabus, actual class. Thank you.